Hi guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, we are going to be talking about my absolute favorite thing in the world to talk about, eyeshadow palettes. I'm going to be sharing with you my top picks for my favorite eyeshadow palettes for the year 2019. Now, if you are interested in my other makeup product favorites for the year, I did just post that video, so check that out. I just had to give eyeshadow palettes their own full video so I can give them all the moment that they deserve. So if you are interested in seeing my favorite eyeshadow palettes, then just keep watching. Eyeshadow palettes are obviously my biggest weakness. I have a huge collection of them. I review them constantly on my channel, so I had a lot of eyeshadow palettes to narrow down. The ones that I chose, these ones are just really what stood out to me this year, what I found myself constantly going back and reaching, or what I found to be extremely inspiring. I'm actually pretty proud because I managed to narrow it down to less than 15 palettes. I'm surprised, honestly, at some of the ones that I left out, and I'm sure you guys will be too. So I think we're going to organize it by price range. So we'll start off with the more luxury items, then go to high-end, and then go to more affordable palettes. So of course we have to start off with Pat McGrath. Let's get the good stuff out of the way. I picked two of her palettes this year that were my favorite. They're probably not going to be a surprise to you. This one in particular is the Bronze Seduction palette. I love the four special shades right here, and then I love the more neutral part of this palette. It just is one of the most inspiring palettes to me that she came out with this year. If you don't watch my channel regularly, Pat McGrath has my favorite eyeshadow formula, so it would be so wrong of me not to put any of her palettes in this video, but this one by far was my favorite palette that she came out with this year. I'm so obsessed with this. It came out earlier this year. I think it's Bergdorf Goodman. They have like a lilac version of this, and I'm honestly considering getting it if they decide to restock it, because this palette is just incredible. I'm super obsessed with this pink color right here, and the duochromes are intense. So such a good palette. I definitely think if you are really into more luxurious makeup products, everybody should invest in at least one Pat McGrath palette. Here's another one to look into, and I feel like my review wasn't as glowing as I actually have ended up loving it, and this is the Midnight Sun palette. So this is the packaging. I don't know where the packaging for the Bronze Seduction went, but here's the packaging for this beauty. And the thing with Pat McGrath, if you aren't familiar, is it's basically like art that you are purchasing. That is why it is so expensive, but the packaging is just super luxurious. So here's what the Midnight Sun looks like. And at first I wasn't super in love with this color story, but as I've gotten to know it more, I really have learned to appreciate it more. It's perfect for every day. Of course, the quality is incredible. I really love this purple shade right here. I mean, as you can see, I always love a good purple shadow look. So this is the color that stands out to me the most. And I really like the tones here on the more neutral side. Great for every day. What I love about Pat McGrath palettes in general is I feel like they are perfect for everybody, because most of the time they have very neutral wearable colors that people can use for every day, and then you have those four special shades where they really glam up the look if you want to play around a little bit. So these two by far were some of my favorite palettes this year that released. Moving into Natasha Denona, again, I picked two palettes. So the first one is the Biba palette. Now this is what the packaging looks like here, and it is an all neutral palette. I mean, let's be honest here, these are the only colors that I really go for on an everyday basis. A lot of people were underwhelmed by this palette, which is obviously very reasonable because they're just boring neutral colors, but that's what you go for, you know? The fact that you can get the everyday colors that you are comfortable with all in one palette in a Natasha Denona formula, like, you can't get better than this palette. This is definitely a staple palette. If you ask me, this is a palette you want to take to travel with you, or if you don't know what kind of makeup look you want to do, I will find myself grabbing for this. It's just great for every day. And then of course the formula in here is incredible. Every single eyeshadow in here is consistent, great quality, blends, it's shiny when it needs to be, it just does what it's supposed to do, blends out super easily. It's really just a foolproof palette. 100% recommend this if you are interested. Again, it might not catch your eye at first, but if you're a neutral wearer, you will probably reach for this palette a lot. And then the next one, which I'm surprised I ended up picking out, is the Metropolis palette from Natasha. And what I liked about this, first off, was that she cut her pan size basically in half and cut the price of the palette in half. So you're getting 28 shades here for literally half the price of her full size 28 pan. So the value of here was consistent with her regular line, and I like that you're paying less for less product, because I have so many eyeshadow palettes, there's no need for me to buy a lot of product. But I love this palette, and at first I was very overwhelmed by it. I thought it was sporadic. I thought some of the colors were too close to each other. The longer I've had this, the more I find myself reaching for it. I find it to be extremely versatile for many different occasions. Now, like I said, I am a neutral color wearer, but just with me doing YouTube and doing makeup in general for Instagram and all of that good stuff, I do actually reach for odd colors quite a lot, and this is a great palette to really amp up a look, make it different, not just an everyday look, but you can also do an everyday look. I really think if you're looking to invest in a very good, more full-size Natasha Denona palette, this is a great way to go, because you do still get a lot of colors. It's not quite as expensive as her other palettes, and you get such a great range. I just think this is a great range for normal people, and it allows you to mix it up if you want to play with your makeup more. That being said, this one is much more neutral, so you'll probably use this more, but this one I just think is really fun. You'll know what colors you use, but I really like this. This was another palette that she came out with that had a very consistent formula with her regular line, that formula that made her brand popular. So this really stole the show for me this year. I also picked out a couple of Tom Ford quads that I wanted to talk about with you guys. Now, I've mentioned this in a few videos. I really got into Tom Ford eyeshadow quads. I've been using them like kind of off camera more so, because I feel like they're just more wearable. I kind of throw them on. They're really great throw on eyeshadow palettes, but I haven't talked about them too much. So I did want to share the two this year that I've been absolutely loving. So we are going to start off with the one that I am currently wearing on my eyes, and this is the Daydream palette. So you guys know how much I love purples, and this is what it looks like. It is really stunning. I know it looks a little scary because they all have that shimmer finish, but I used three of the shades on my eyes today, and it's completely fine without having any mattes. I love the formula in here. You can use these wet or dry, and these are just absolutely stunning colors. The thing with Tom Ford eyeshadows that make them different from many others is I feel that there's just something so elegant about the way that they look on the eye that you just don't get with a lot of other shadows. With the Tom Ford shadows, you're not really going to get very defined looks or very intricate looks like the things you see on Instagram. These are really about everyday wear, throwing them on, looking elegant and pretty, and that's just how I feel about the line. Super soft, really great stuff. So if you like purple, Daydream is absolutely stunning. I stared at it at the counters every time I went to a Tom Ford counter, and finally this year I decided to get it, and I do not regret it. The other one that I really enjoy is African Violet. Now this one I feel like it's pretty unique to his line. I think that's why I like it so much. It just kind of stands out. So in here you're getting two mattes, and then you're getting a shimmer, and then a bit more of a metallic. So this one I like because you are getting a range of different finishes. It's probably not as unique as I think it is, but specifically in his line it's very unique. Again, here we are with the purple. You know how I feel about that. And then you get really warm tones. I really like purple with warm tones sometimes. I think it looks really good. So I think this is a really pretty mix of colors. These three, if you want a more neutral look, you can add the purple in for a little bit of pop. But I really enjoy this one. I think it is very different. It's very pretty. The quality blends like butter. Tom Ford is not a brand that you want to invest in if you don't have the money. However, if you do have the money, they are really special to own, and I really enjoy the experience that I have wearing them and applying them and how they make me feel. Not a necessity, but a really great treat yourself item, because you're only getting four shadows, but he has some beautiful quads in his line. I know I need to do a video on the quads that I have, but moving on, one of my favorite palettes this year is from Viseart, and this is the Liaison palette. Now that I'm looking, there's like a lot of purple palettes in here. You'll you can see what kind of colors I always go towards. This palette is so phenomenal. I feel like the quality in here is better than most VisiArt shadows, which is a big statement because their shadows are one of the best in the business to begin with. But I am so in love with the curation of this palette. I just think the colors that they decided to pair together just really makes sense. It really makes it very easy to create a look on the eye without having to think too hard. I love these really cool taupey purple colors to start off the look, and the shimmers in here are absolutely insane. They're the kind of color where it'll go all the way down your arm. They're so creamy and pigmented, and every time I wear this palette I create such a stunning look. If you've been eyeing this palette, I would recommend that you pick it up. It was one of my favorites this year, one of the best VisiArt has ever come out with. So I hope to see them come out with another one of these nine pan kind of color story palettes sometime soon. If they're as great as this one, oh my gosh, any color story would be great. The next palette that we have is from Huda Beauty, and this is a newer palette. This is the Mercury Retrograde palette, and I love everything about this palette, from the packaging to the concept to the color stories to the quality. I just think it is a fantastic palette. Now, I will be completely upfront in that I haven't used this palette a ton because the colors in here aren't the most wearable for me. However, every time I do use it, I am so in love with the look that I create. I think the reason why this is one of my favorite shadow palettes of the year is simply because it is such a unique concept. I don't have a palette like this in my collection. The textures in here are really fun and can just create a really pretty galactic look. And of course, we do have a lot of purple shades and just really fun shades in here. I wish I could use this palette more than I have, but it's just not everyday kind of friendly, but it's one of those palettes where it makes me happy to own. I feel inspired having it in my hand. I like to swatch it. I mean, Huda always does such a fabulous job with their palette releases, but I feel like they really did step outside of the box with this one, and they did a very good job with it. I have a couple of ABH palettes that I wanted to share with you, and so the first one I wanted to talk about is the Jackie Ina collaboration palette from ABH. This palette isn't really geared for the type of makeup wearer that I am. The only time I really use this palette is if I want a really deep eye, but this palette creates quite a statement on the eye, which I really like. This palette never really got its full moment because ABH all of a sudden went crazy and started releasing all of these palettes, so I definitely wanted to give this palette a moment because the colors in here are beautiful. This palette is beautifully curated. You can create a lot of different looks with this palette, and that's what I think makes it really special, is the amount of looks you can get is endless. You can get a neutral look, you can get a purple look, you can get a rainbow look. It really is such a unique palette, and the way that Jackie curated it, she did a fabulous job, so it's super versatile. This came out towards the end of summer. The quality of it is really nice, and I just really like how inspired I feel when I have this palette in my hands and all of the different looks that I imagine creating. Love the colors that she chose. Really wonderful palette. If this is limited edition, I would say definitely pick it up if you can before it sells out, because it's a really fabulous palette. It's not a palette that I reach for every day, but it is a palette that really like sparks joy inside of me, you know? The next one, I'm very surprised that I'm showing it, but it is so good, and every look I create, I love it. And this is the Norvina Volume 1. I feel bad mentioning it because, I don't know, this whole release of all three of them in like a month was ridiculous, but I can't deny that this palette isn't absolutely amazing. I feel like the quality in here is better than the regular ABH formula. You can create some really neat, unique looks with this palette. And I mean, I'm really just bragging on this palette because I was shook by the quality. I want her to come out with a big one like this of pure like neutrals, and I feel like the collection would be complete with a whole palette of neutrals. But no, honestly, like I think the shimmers are in here are phenomenal. All of the mattes blend beautifully, and this is a majority purple palette, and with those types of pigments it can be hard to create a good shadow, but they really did it with this. I was highly impressed by this. This is the one I would recommend you pick up if you are interested in it. I genuinely would be lying if I didn't say this is one of my favorite palettes that released this year. All right, so the last few are more affordable items. I want to take a moment to talk about Kaleidos eyeshadow palettes. They are an indie brand. I think they are a brand that is really onto something. They're creating a very unique brand. The concept of it is very unique and they're just bringing something different to the table. So they have a few, I believe about 6 eyeshadow palettes out. I picked my top 3 to share with you guys because they are stunning. They're pretty affordable palettes and I just love the packaging of them. These are their Futurism eyeshadow palettes and they're very similar concepts to Pat McGrath. Like this reminds me of Pat McGrath, but like 10% of the price and just super gorgeous palettes. The quality is really nice. It's not amazing luxury quality eyeshadows. There are some particular shadows that do require a little bit more work, but they are affordable and I think sometimes we forget that. So not the best quality ever, but it's good quality and the colors are amazing and their shimmer formula is really, really good. So their mattes I think could use a little bit more work, but their shimmers are phenomenal. So this one is the Futurism 1 Sci-Fi Green. So if you like this color story, I would recommend that one. I also really love the color story of Futurism 3 Astro Pink. So take a look at this packaging. Like such a unique, cool concept that this brand has. I'm telling you, this turquoise is so unbelievably incredible. And I just really love these shades right here, even the mattes. To the shimmers. This is just a really great curated palette in particular as well. And then they came out with a couple of other palettes a few months later, and this is the Electric Turquoise, and this one was super fun for the summer. Again, these particular shimmers are amazing, and I just really love how inspired this brand makes me feel. I feel like they have some really fresh ideas in the industry that are just really unique. So definitely keep an eye out for this brand. They create really great stuff. Make sure you support them so that they continue to grow because they have a lot to offer in the makeup industry for the future. So the last two palettes that I chose are from ColourPop. I really tried to give you guys a nice range, and ColourPop is one of my favorite affordable eyeshadow brands. I'm very picky about eyeshadows. Typically, I prefer high-end luxury shadows, but ColourPop really does a good job for their price range. Definitely, I'm not saying they have luxury quality eyeshadows. I can tell a difference. But these get the job done. I'm highly impressed. I would say these work at about a high-end range kind of quality point. So the first one that I want to talk about is the Sweet Talk palette. This collection from ColourPop was by far my favorite collection that they came out with. I wish I had purchased more, but I didn't at that time. But I really love this palette. Now it does have a couple glitters that I know a lot of you guys don't like, but I love the tones in here. It was perfect for the spring and summer, and I just found myself reaching for this palette a lot. I just feel like every look I create with this palette, it's really feminine and soft and very pretty, and it's just one of my favorite palettes that ColourPop has ever come out with in general. One of my favorite palettes that I've used this year. I've not heard anybody say they don't like ColourPop shadows. Even, you know, all of my subscribers, we love luxury makeup, and a lot of you guys have told me that you also like ColourPop because they create good products and the packaging is cute too. The other palette that I loved, this is a new one, but I am head over heels for, is their Going Coconuts palette. So this is from one of their 9 pan monochromatic palettes. They have a whole collection. I think some are better than others, but for the most part, if there's a color story you're kind of looking for, definitely look into that line. They're super cheap, especially if you get them while they're on sale. I think I got this for like $8, but all my neutral lovers, this palette is absolutely amazing. I think this is going to be my new travel palette for a while. It has all of the neutrals that I love and I'm comfortable with and I feel like are very flattering on me, very metallic shades, and then the perfect crease shade in every shade with every depth so that I can really blend and create depth in my makeup looks. This one was my favorite ColourPop palette for a while, but this one has definitely taken over. So good, and the quality is very great as well. For $8, it just, I don't know how ColourPop does it, honestly. That is all I have for today's video. We had a lot of talk about palettes, my favorite thing to talk about. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I really do feel like I'm leaving palettes out, but I, you know, I had to be cutthroat in this one. I didn't want it to be another hour long video. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I hope you found it helpful. I want you to comment your top 3 favorite eyeshadow palettes of this year down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you are not yet subscribed to my channel, I sure do hope you take the time to do so. I hope you are still working on your New Year's resolutions, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys, have a good one.